हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मैं आज आप लोगों के लिए एक रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर जी की लिखी पोयम लेके आया हूँ, वेयर द माइंड इज विदाउट फियर। पोयम से हमें काफी कुछ जानने और सीखने को मिलता है, और ऐसे ही हमारे रिस्पेक्टेड रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर जी ने हमें काफी कुछ चीजें, काफी कविताएं, काफी शॉर्ट स्टोरीज दी हैं, जिससे हमें बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिलता है। आज उन्हीं की कुछ कविताओं में से एक पोयम मैं आप लोगों के बीच लेके आया हूँ। And the poem says that the mind where we stay without fear. Actually, Rabindranath Tagore was a very good poet, and it is one of the best poem today I have taken. That is from the anthology that is called Gitanjali, published in 1912, and won a prestigious Nobel Prize in 1913. The poem had been created by Rabindranath Tagore when he was in imprisonment, in the slavery. That yes, I was talking the time about British's rule, when the British ruled India. That's the time when the people of India are having lots of superstitions, and the poem is for their awakening. Basically, the poem has said so many things to the Indian. Let's know about the poem. सबसे जरूरी चीज ये भी है साथ में कि एग्जाम के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू नहीं, साथ साथ में हम पोएम को ये भी सीखने की कोशिश करते हैं कि पोएम कहना क्या चाहती है, और हमें हमारे इतिहास के बारे में पता रहना चाहिए ताकि हमें काफी कुछ जानने और सीखने को मिलता है, जैसे कि इस पोएम से। पोएम शुरू करता हूं मैं। पोएम में रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर जी ने कहा है, Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. Poem में रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर जी प्रे करते हैं गॉड से और कहते हैं that the countryman should be free from any fear. That means at that time the people not have that much awareness. तो यहाँ पे जो रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर जी हैं वो गॉड से प्रे करते हैं और कहते हैं कि लोगों को फ्री होना चाहिए, फियर नहीं होना चाहिए उनके अंदर। उनकी विश थी, रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर जी की विश थी, एवरीवन हैज कंट्री हैज हैड हाई इन डिग्निटी। बेसिकली उनका जो सर, हम जितने भी लोग हैं, हम सबका सर हमेशा गर्व से उठा रहना चाहिए, डाउन नहीं रहना चाहिए। फिर आगे वो क्या करें, वेल नॉलेज इज फ्री। एट दैट टाइम द प्रॉब्लम इज ओनली द रिचर क्लास और द अपर क्लास हैव द राइट्स ऑफ एजुकेशन। But the definitely Tagore ji in his poem says that the education is the rights of everyone. Today's also this is the basic thing. Each and every people should have a good education. तो उस वक्त में उन्होंने अपने poem के जरिए चीज लानी चाहिए कि हर एक व्यक्ति, that means every people, there was a dream, the dream of that poet that where knowledge is free, education should not be restricted to the only one section or one class only. That means everybody has the rights to acquire knowledge. After that, what the Tagore ji say, where the world has not been broken up into fragmented by narrow domestic walls. That means what he want to say, he want to say that there should be no division among people. People based on their caste, people based on their religion, this all are the baseless superstition. We cannot differentiate the people on the basis of their caste, on the basis of their religion. Basically, in that time he knows that. In that time he wrote in his poem that we all are equal. This all religious, caste, cultures not make us different. After that in his poem he said that there is a small domestic walls are created, or narrow domestic walls. That what is the narrow domestic walls here? It indicates that superstitions of the people. Because of that superstition, we differentiated different cultures. After that, where words come out from the depth of truth. Basically, Tagore ji also know that ke aaj ke time pe aur us time pe bhi ek cheez thodi common dekhne ko milti hai. Kya? People are talk on the basis of their need, but not the Tagore ji wants. The Tagore ji wants that कि एक ऐसा टाइम आना चाहिए, या वहां जितने भी लोग हैं वो बात जब करें, हाउ दे टॉक, देयर शुड बी, टैगोर जी वांट्स अ नेशन दैट वेयर पीपल आर ट्रूथफुल। जहां लोग क्या करते हैं, तो लोग सच बोलते हैं. Their words should come out from depth of the heart. That means you should be very true for all your aspects. After that, well, tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. That means यहां कहना क्या चाहते हैं टैगोर जी? टैगोर जी इस पोयम में, इस लाइन के जरिए आपको बताना चाहते हैं, no need to become lazy. And if you want to get a success, then definitely you have to work hard. Basically, what the Tagore ji want to say? Tagore ji wants that everyone to work hard. हर एक व्यक्ति क्या करना चाहिए? मुश्किल अच्छे से hard work करना चाहिए to reach your goal. That means if you have a certain goal in your mind, what should you have to do? अभी आज के दौर में हम देखें तो लोग क्या कर ले जाते हैं? लोग अपने माइंड से थोड़ी थोड़ी एक्टिविटीज में डाइवर्ट कर ले जाते हैं. सोचते हैं कि चलो ये काम नहीं हो रहा है, ये मुझसे नहीं होगा. हाउ यू कैन सी दैट द वर्क कैन नॉट बी डन बाय यू, दैट कैन बी इजीली डन. मुश्किल थोड़ी है, कोशिश करना होता है. एक बार ट्राई करके देखना, नहीं हुआ फिर ट्राई करके देखो. और जब आप थोड़ी दूर तक आ जाओ और नहीं हो रहा है, तो एक बार ये सोचो तो सही कि आपने शुरुआत कहां से की थी, कहां से शुरुआत की थी, कहां तक आ गए हो. थोड़ी सी दूरी और है, हिम्मत नहीं हारनी चाहिए. हमें इस पोयम के इस लाइन से ये सीखने को मिलता है दैट वॉन्ट्स एवरी वन, एवरीबडी शुड वॉन्ट, एवरीबडी शुड डू सिलेक्ट अ वेरी गुड पाथ. एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट यू हैव टू वर्क वेरी हार्ड एंड टू रीच योर गोल. एंड नॉट ओनली दैट, नेवर और नो नीड टू टायर्ड बाय वर्किंग. दैट मीन्स नो नीड टू टायर्ड. आप वर्किंग करते करते कैसे टायर्ड? यू शुड बी वेरी एनर्जेटिक एंड शुड बी वेरी एक्टिव इन योर वर्क. एंड आफ्टर दैट पीपल शुड नॉट बी लेजी. दैट इज द बेसिक पॉइंट दैट Tagore ji वांट्स टू एक्सप्लेन इन दिस पॉइंट. आफ्टर दैट ही सेज दैट वेयर द क्लियर स्ट्रीम ऑफ रीजन हैज नॉट लॉस्ट इट्स वे इन टू द ड्रियरी ड्रियरी डेजर्ट सैंड ऑफ डेथ हैबिट. मीन्स इफ यू सी दैट Tagore ji वांट्स दैट आवर थिंकिंग शुड नॉट बी our thinking should not be like we can say that superstition thinking we have, that should not be necessary. What should we have to do? We should have our thinking rational, logically we have to think, not on the basis of that the way the people are moving in the wrong path you should have to be go on that similar path. You should have to select your own path, and on the basis of it identify that which portion you are. And after that, what the Tagore ji wants to say, where the mind is led forward by the into ever widening thought and action into the heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. At last, what he wants to say, he says that people should be open-minded, and what should they have to select? They should have to select an extraordinary work which is necessary. On the basis of that only you can get the success, overcoming narrowness of mind. That is also an important thing which is necessary. Definitely you all have to think about it, how we have to work. And at last he made the prayer to God. The God, please understand the all awakening message to all our country members or countrymen. Because of that the people are aware and go on the right path. The poem messages at that time also and today's time also that be loyal, be honest to your work, to your relatives, and also to your colleagues. And this is a very good message to you. Never be lazy to your work. Have very good, powerful, creative energy and more work on yourself. That is the poem you should have. And still, if you want to more, and it is just the beginning. So many lessons and poems I'm going to bring for all of you. So you should get a very good message from the poem. And also, one thing. When you learn this, I want a short message and short inspiration quote from you in the comment. What you have get it from this poem? I also get it, so I am also going to comment on it. Hope so you guys are understanding what the poem want to explain. Understand it properly. Note down all the points and write down in your exams. That should be very beneficial to you. And also give the message which the poem want to explain to you. That is from my side. Thank you.